Hey guys, Carlos Perez, and I'm going to do a quick little video just showing you some of the best practices when using your Pyro Media Center. First thing I like to tell people to do is get familiar with this little dude right here. That little dude is your rocket cleaner. That's going to clear your cache. When you click on that, it's going to free up space. And I do that whenever I exit out of the media center. When you exit out the media center, and then I'll turn my box off. I'll turn it off by hitting the cursor key and then coming all the way down here to this lower black row, going over there, and then clicking OK on it, and then just turning off the cursor and going to either sleep, reboot, or power off. Another thing is the IPTV service. The IPTV service, I go in there, and if I'm using it outside of the box, I will just watch a lot of the programming there. It just seems to be really stable, so I'm going to pause this and log in. Okay, I'm hitting log in now. Going to get in there, and I tend to watch a lot of my stuff really quickly just using this first row live TV. I don't use the guide. I'm not really concerned with what time something comes on usually if I'm doing live TV. For those of you that are, the guide, is always being updated. So you have that access. And then I typically, because most of the things I'm going to watch are really USA, so I'll just load USA or UK if I'm trying to find UK stuff. Latino for, for my Latino, Canada, or US local. But I tend to, normally stay in the USA area, so I'll do that. And there's two formats. You see up in the top, up in that top left corner, that menu. If you go over to the right menu, you can have it show as a list view or grid view. So this is grid view. If I go up to list view, just going to just list everything straight down. Grid view puts it back in the grid. And then, of course, you can refresh your channel list. And then you can refresh your TV guide. And I have the tendency to do that just to make sure everything is always up to date. I'll do it. So that's like a good practice, a good common practice for you guys when watching things. Again, if you're just watching, everything right there. Just pick the one you want because it's usually, if you go all, that's 811 channels to scroll through. If you're just doing USA, it's 171. If you're going down to like your CNN, like I'm hooked on CNN every day waiting for Trump to do something, and I'll just click on that and I'll just load my CNN from there and just watch, everything I want to watch there. Or if I'm doing my Cartoon Network or something, it's like one of those days my daughter and I were watching TV, but we're in, different rooms, different locations. I'll pop it on, she'll pop it on, and we're watching TV. So that's one of the best habits for watching it right there. And one of the good habits for watching the actual media center, we're going to load that up, is I do have my subscription to the Reel to Bread. The Reel to Bread, there's nothing like it. If you want to make sure you always have access to content, then you want to use the Reel to Bread service. Trust me, it's $40 a year if you order it from them directly, or it can go down as low as 30. 32, 35, if you use one of the resellers, because they'll take an Amazon gift card for the amount. So the Reel to Bread service is something you're definitely going to want to use, and I'm going to show you the why you want it. So Reel to Bread data is being saved, everything's updated, everything's fine. So if I'm going on to TV shows, I have the Reel to Bread hooked up to Exodus, and I have it hooked up to Covenant, Placenta, Chappia, Antrox, and Neptune Rising. They, once you hook up Exodus and you hook up Covenant, because they use either the resolver URL or URL resolver, they will also be added. And let me show you just what the difference is. If I go into Exodus, and for today, I'm going to pull up my TV calendar. So when I'm pulling up my TV calendar, go over here. This brings up my shows that come on today. So with my shows that come on today, Monday, September 3rd, when I click on that, you're going to notice that a lot of shows are going to come up on the lineup. Now it's Monday. I forgot what I watch on Monday. If you guys remember, I do have this synced to my Google Calendar. But let's just see what's on. So is there anything I watched today? Ah, I watched Salvation. So if I click on Salvation, having the real the bread, you see there's two lines that show up. There's the premium and the normal. As this scrolls through, it's going to pick up all of the links. Now, the normal links are the free ones that are out there. And a lot of people have been complaining, saying that a lot of things are down. A lot of add-ons are not working. And, you know, guys, they do updates. They do close out servers. You know, if your build is constantly being updated like we do, we update our build continuously, you know, you won't have so many problems. Now, you see all of these blue. All these blue ones are the premium links, and down here, these white ones are the free links. So the free links do play, but the premium ones, because you know you're paying for these just work a little bit better, and it's worth paying that $40 a year in order to have the premium links that you know are just going to play better. Now, again, guys, this is choppy because I'm recording from my TV to the computer. So that's why it's choppy, but it's flawless when you're looking at it. So that's one thing that I use for my TVs and movies, because it also allows you to get the premium movie links. So if I'm going over here to my movie section, I click on Exodus, and I want to show you. I was watching Superfly, and I guess what people watching. Or did I do a search? I think I did a search. Let me see. Did I do a search? Yeah, I did a search. So you click on Superfly, and they did have some free links out there playing it, but they were really, really not a great quality. Not something that I would want to watch. So you see, it's pulling back 1080p links that the free ones don't have. And I was able to sit down and watch this whole movie straight through, flawless, no pausing, no stuttering, no skipping, no buffering. I mean, seamless. But that's because of those premium links. So I don't know if I can emphasize this enough. You know, if you're really, really trying to cut the cord, you want to be able to enjoy television, then it is recommended that you get that one service. The Real the Bread service is going to just make everything you're trying to view that much better. So as you can see, you know, it's 1080p, it's super clear. And guys, I don't have any problem with this. So movies and TV shows are covered. The two resolvers, the reason why you're connecting Covenant and Exodus is that one uses resolver URL, the other one uses URL resolver. So by connecting both of those, you're actually accessing both of those resolvers and you're putting them on the DeBread service. So that right there is helpful. If you're watching the entertainment content, it holds a lot of data. So if you watch a good amount of it, it's going to fill up your memory and you're not going to be able to access it. So whenever you're done with that and you exit out, that's where that cache cleaner comes in handy, and just turning off the box until you're ready to use it again and turning it back on, because it clears out everything. Now, when you boot the box back up, it's going to clear out the memory here, but the memory that would have prevented you from being able to access the media center is going to be clean the moment you hit the little rocket dude and you shut the box down. So that's my best practices for watching movies and TV shows and getting the most out of your pyro media center. And again, guys, spending that money on Reel the Bread, and then the fact that we constantly update and we connect a lot of things, is really going to make a big, huge difference in how you're able to really enjoy stuff. So as you see, I just cleared the cache. I'm going over and I'm going to shut down the power, which in this case, I'm just going to reboot. And doing that, this video is done, guys. So that's the best viewing habits for watching. And you'll notice that when I clicked the rocket dude, it was at 600, I think 95 megs. You'll probably experience that same thing, but after you turn it off, turn it back on, you'll be at 1 gig to 1.5 gigs. So you'll see that clearing everything out is really helpful. It prevents you from having a bad experience. Having the Reel the Bread also makes everything that much better. Thank you guys, and enjoy watching television and being unplugged with the Pyro Media Center.